Come along with me to a week-long physics conference in Berlin, Germany, where I gave my first ever conference talk. Alongside the serious research, there was also plenty of downtime to sightsee and have fun with my group in the evenings. Before leaving, I did a little dress rehearsal of my talk at home to an imaginary audience. Then I was off, so cue travel montage. I've been to a few conferences now during my PhD, but this was going to be the biggest one yet. 3,600 talks over 5 days. And, for the first time, one of these many talks would be mine. This conference was also particularly exciting, because most of my group was going, 9 of us sharing a big Airbnb. And the venue was in Berlin, one of my favourite European cities, and I hadn't been back since interrailing there 5 years prior. On our arrival, we had a slightly chaotic evening arranging the rooms, eating at a donor place, and of course sampling the German beer. Then on Monday morning, we registered for the conference and spent the morning watching different talks. One of the perks of PhD conference travel is that you can expense food, so we got to have a nice lunch with German food, which beats the usual packed lunch I bring to the office.
The conference was pretty good this morning. There were some interesting talks, and it was nice just to walk around and absorb the atmosphere and go out for a nice lunch. But now this afternoon, me and a couple of the others have come back to the apartment just to have a rest and do our own work, and I'm gonna spend some time talking to myself and practicing my talk a bit in preparation for tomorrow.
How can increasing disorder in a system actually induce global order, where we introduce quite disorder in a new way to our system, and we are able to find both blocking behaviour and self-organisation?
When everyone got back in the evening, we had a nice night in playing games, including very competitive Mario Kart.
Then more chaos ensued. How many PhD students does it take to open a wine bottle with no corkscrew? Then Emir cooked us some yummy Turkish food for dinner, and I went to bed before my big day on Tuesday.
My talk this morning at 9:30, so I've just gone ahead of everyone to get there nice and early and set up and check all the equipment is working. I'm not feeling too nervous actually. In the past I found public speaking a bit harder, but I practice it lots, and it's nice to talk about my research with other people, so yeah, hopefully it goes well.
The talk was only 12 minutes long, plus a few questions, but it can be hard to effectively convey complicated ideas in such a short time.
So first, I'm just going to remind you about the bit check model, or as it can be called, the bit.
The talk went really well, I think. And so this afternoon it's sunny, so I'm taking the opportunity just to go for a little jog around Tiergarten, the big park in Berlin, to de-stress and just have some time by myself, and it's really nice.
Well, this little 3 kilometer jog turned into a proper 6k run, as I was enjoying myself so much in the sun and seeing some sights. Our week of international cultures continued when the Chinese students in our group took us out to a Chinese place in the evening before we watched a performance at the Berlin Philharmonie. On Wednesday morning, my part in the conference wasn't quite over, as I also had a poster session to talk at for a few hours. This is an event where other students and academics can browse different posters and ask questions about it as more of a discussion format. The only downside is I usually find these sessions really tiring, but I was brought back to life by trying my first ever curry burst. Then I attended more talks in the afternoon. Physics of beer foam and zombie apocalypse, is anyone? Finally, I got to relax after a tiring day, playing more games with my group back at the flat.
Because I think that
On Thursday and Friday were more talks, with a bit of sightseeing and secret cake missions in between. Side note, it's surprisingly difficult to find birthday cake in Germany, but it was worth it to surprise Jacob and the group with some early birthday celebrations. It was also nice on Friday to go and support other PhD students in my group and present their own talks. Finally, the long week of conferencing came to an end, but I stayed on one more night to catch up with an old uni friend in the city. After a packed week, I headed home to London to catch up on sleep and to get back to the usual PhD routine. But on the journey home, I got to reflect on what I think might be my favourite conference so far. Thanks for watching. Let me know what else you'd like to see about my life as a PhD student.